In today's video, I am going to explain basic anatomy and function of rotator cuff. Rotator cuff. There are four muscles in rotator cuff. Let me explain location of each muscle first. First muscle is this one. This is supraspinatus. Supraspinatus. This one is infraspinatus. Supraspinatus and infraspinatus. If this feels difficult for you, there's one tip to memorize these two muscles. This part is spine of scapula. Spine of scapula. From spine of scapula, if you go up superior, there is supraspinatus. From spine of scapula, if you go inferior, there is infraspinatus. So this is how I remember. Spine of scapula, above, supraspinatus. Spine of scapula, below, infraspinatus. It's simple, right? Now let's go back to anatomy. This one is teres minor. Teres minor. 1, 2, 3. Where is the fourth one? Actually, it is on front part. This is front view of scapula. Last one is this one. This is subscapularis. Subscapularis. Alright, we have four muscles. Supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and subscapularis. These are names of rotator cuff. Now, let's go to each single muscle. Alright, let me explain supraspinatus first. Where is origin of supraspinatus? Where does it originate from? It originates from here, this kind of concave surface of scapula. This is supraspinal fossa. Supraspinal fossa. Fossa means concave surface. This is origin. Insertion is here. This is part of humerus. This is greater tubercle. Greater tubercle, right here. Origin, supraspinal fossa. Insertion, greater tubercle. Now, what is function of supraspinatus? It is shoulder abduction. Shoulder abduction. Abduction is you raise shoulder kind of sideways. This is abduction. By the way, this muscle is so important for shoulder abduction. There are two main shoulder abductors in human body. First one is, of course, supraspinatus. Second one is deltoid. Deltoid covers shoulder like this. That is huge muscle. Because this muscle is so big, that moves shoulder a lot. Then, supraspinatus also does shoulder abduction, but this is tiny muscle. So, this muscle is also important for shoulder stabilization. This is freaking important thing. Alright, supraspinatus. That originates from supraspinal fossa. That inserts to greater tubercle. Function is abduction. Let's go to infraspinatus. Okay, infraspinatus is here. Where does it originate from? That originates from infraspinal fossa. Infraspinal fossa. Do you remember how you memorize terminology? Criteria is spine of scapula. This is below infraspinal fossa. That's simple, right? Supraspinal fossa, that is above. Okay. Then, insertion is here. This is also greater tubercle. Greater tubercle, it's like supraspinatus. That's simple, right? Okay, function of infraspinatus. That is external rotation. external rotation of shoulder. Infraspinal fossa, greater tubercle, and external rotation. Let's go to teres minor. Teres minor is this one. That originates from here, this part. Don't see that, but there is border like that. This is lateral border. Lateral border of scapula. Then that inserts to here. This is also greater tubercle. Alright, three of rotator cuff muscles insert to greater tubercle. They attach very close each other. This is important thing. I will show you from different angle later. Function of teres minor, that is external rotation. External rotation. Infraspinatus and teres minor do external rotation. Let's go to profile view. This is profile view. This one is supraspinatus. This is infraspinatus. And this part is teres minor. See, these muscles attach very close position, right? Because they are deep and because they are close each other, they are very close to shoulder joint capsule. Joint capsule. It's like literally capsule of joint. So when these muscles, including subscapularis, of course, when these muscles get tight or inflammation, that affects for shoulder joint very directly because they are literally close to shoulder joint. Here, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, they attach to greater tubercle. Now let's go to last one, that is subscapularis. This is again anterior view. This is subscapularis. Where does it originate from? This originates from subscapular fossa. Subscapular fossa. But fossa means concave surface. It doesn't look like it's concave surface. Actually, that is concave surface. Let's go to profile view again. See, there is kind of slight concave surface on anterior part. You see this concave surface on profile view, but you don't see that on front view. This is why you should see anatomy on 360 degrees, and you should see anatomy from different angle. Okay, this is subscapular fossa, and that inserts to humerus, but this is not greater tubercle. This is lesser tubercle. Let's go back to profile view again. Other three muscles attach to greater tubercle. These three muscles are very close. Subscapularis attach a little bit far away from these three muscles. Now, this place is lesser tubercle. Okay? Subscapularis is tiny bit far away from other three muscles. But that does not mean this muscle is not important. This is very important. This is very deep. This is very thin muscle. Thus, this is also important for shoulder stability. What is function of subscapularis? This is internal rotation. Internal rotation because that pulls humerus this way. Okay, this is front view. When subscapularis pulls humerus this way, what's going to happen? That is internal rotation. One more important thing of subscapularis. There should be rib cage in front of scapula, like this. And scapula and rib cage don't have articulation. Articulation means there's joint between bone and bone, like clavicle and scapula. There's no bone connection between rib cage and scapula. Okay, there's only space here. Subscapularis is in space between scapula and ribcage. And there's one more important muscle in this space. Let's go to different view. That is this muscle. This is serratus anterior. serratus anterior is located between rib cage and scapula, so it's like subscapularis. Remember, there is no bone connection between scapula and rib cage. Then there is serratus anterior and subscapularis. What happens if these muscles get tight? That creates adhesion or tightness around space between rib cage and scapula. What's going to happen then? There is less movement on scapula. Imagine there's gliding surface between rib cage and scapula. If these two muscles get tight, there's less space, there's less mobility for gliding surface. That is why subscapularis is important. This is not only for shoulder movement, but it's also important for ribcage-scapula relationship. In today's video, I explained basic anatomy and function of rotator cuff. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.